Hello everyone! My recent video on Another Toronto got a decent feedback and lots of questions about how did I achieve those transitions. So here it is, a tutorial on weep, swoosh, blur, Turkish transitions. First of all, you have to make an editing in your software. I prefer doing it in Adobe Premiere Pro and then transfer the sequence into Adobe After Effects. In this case, you have all the cuts at the right time and you know when the transition is going to finish. As you can see, the bird freezes for a bit and then the transition happens. Right click on the layer, go to time, enable timer mapping. This gives you an ability to make what's called time ramps. Time ramp is an effect when the speed of your video is not linear. In our case, we wanted to play at normal speed and then slow down right before the transition. You make a keyframe when you want the bird to freeze and you make another one while the bird is still in the frame. And then you stretch it. So the distance between frames is bigger, this means that the video is going to be slower. Now I have choppy footage because I'm missing some frames right here, and to make it smooth, you can use frame blending. It has two options. It mixes frames that sit close to each other, or it builds missing frames based on motion of pixels. This is what we need right here because we have a bird and a flat background. I want to do the same with the other shot. Now we have two shots prepared for the transition. The idea is to find something in common, such as an object or a form, color, silhouette, and then blend it together. Let's make some position, scale, and opacity keyframes when you want your transition to happen. Speaking of length, I find it ideal to be 3-5 frames, but it depends on the shots you have and how well you can blend it. I want to take the second shot, make it transparent so I can see both at the same time and adjust the position and scale so it almost matches the first shot. I jump to the end of transition and overlap the first shot with the second. So now I want to turn on the motion blur because this is what makes the motion look natural. To get rid of the borders, you want to make the mask around your object and then use mask expansion animation to reveal the background. Here it is again how it looks in a video. If you watch the transition frame by frame, you get the idea easily. If you have any questions, let me know. Thanks for watching.